Hello class 8, hope you all are doing well and concentrating in your studies. Students, still some of you are not regular with your assignments. So if any assignment is pending, just complete it and send that assignment as soon as possible. Students, this is your last video of chemistry before first terminal examination. So, in this video, I'm going to continue the same chapter, that is your elements, compounds and mixture. And today, we will discuss about the two methods of separation of mixture, that is your what? Chromatography and centrifugation. And I'll also discuss a few exercises of this chapter. Let's start the chapter. To separate the components of a complex mixture, we use two methods, chromatography and centrifugation. Chromatography is a separation technique used to separate the different components in a liquid mixture. There are different types of chromatographic techniques such as column chromatography, thin layer chromatography, paper chromatography, gas chromatography. But the paper chromatography is one of the important chromatographic methods. Paper chromatography uses paper as the stationary phase and liquid solvent as the mobile phase. In paper chromatography, a spot of the mixture is put on the paper and the paper is carefully dipped into a solvent. The solvent rises up the paper due to the capillary action and the components of the mixture rise up at different rates and thus get separated from one another. Let's discuss the process of chromatography, and for that we require a mixture of red and blue inks, distilled water, isopropyl alcohol, Wattmann filter paper, and whose measurement is about 20 by 2 cm, then capillary tube. Then take a Wattmann filter paper strip, draw a line with a pencil above 4 cm from one end, draw another line lengthwise from the center then of the paper, and name the point at which the two lines intersect as P. Then take a capillary tube, dip it into a beaker containing a mixture of red and blue inks, and take the mixture using the capillary tube. Then put a drop of the mixture of red and blue ink at the point P. Allow it to dry in open air. Again take mixture of red and blue ink using capillary tube. Then put another drop on the same spot and dry it again so that the spot is rich in mixture. Take 5 ml of distilled water in a measuring cylinder and pour it into a chromatographic chamber. Then take 5 ml of isopropyl alcohol in a measuring cylinder and pour it into a chromatographic chamber containing distilled water. Mix the contents of the chromatographic chamber using a glass rod. This mixture is used as a solvent. Take the filter paper and suspend the filter paper vertically in the chromatographic chamber containing solvent in such a way that the pencil line remains about 2 cm above the solvent level. Close the chamber and keep it undisturbed for some time. Now notice the rise in solvent along with the mixture of red and blue ink. When the solvent has risen about 15 cm, you will notice two different spots of blue and red colors on the filter paper. Next method is your centrifugation. Finally suspended solid components in liquid are separated by spinning the mixture in a closed container at a very high speed, and this is called what? Centrifugation.
It is used to separate the components of a mixture based on the difference in density. Heavier particles experience a larger centrifugal force than the lighter particles. Let's discuss the process of centrifugation. For centrifugation, we require milk, distilled water, centrifuge tubes, centrifuge machine. Take a centrifuge and fill 3/4 of it with the milk. Place the centrifuge tube in one of the holes of the rotor of the centrifuge tube. Take another centrifuge tube and fill 3/4 of it with distilled water. Place it opposite to the first centrifuge tube to balance the centrifuge machine. Then close the centrifuge machine and centrifuge the milk for 2 minutes and then stop the machine. Take the centrifuge tube containing milk from the machine and observe the changes. The fat rises to the top, resulting in a cream layer at the top and skim milk plasma phase of milk at the bottom, and the denser particle forced to the bottom, and the lighter particles stay at the top when spun rapidly. In this way, cream is separated from milk by centrifugation. Let's discuss exercises of chapter 4. Now question number 12 is your explain the diagrams, the process used to separate the following substances from the given mixture. Here I'm explaining only the method, okay? I'm just telling you the name of the method which you will use to separate the components of a mixture, given components of the mixture. Now first is your ammonium chloride from a mixture of ammonium chloride and potassium chloride. Which method you will use? You use sublimation method. Why? Because ammonium chloride is a sublimable solid. Second is your iron from a mixture of iron and copper. You know iron is a magnetic substance. So to separate iron from a mixture of iron and copper, you will use magnetic separation. C is your sulfur from a mixture of sulfur and copper. Which method you will use? Solvent extraction. Why? Because sulfur is soluble and copper is insoluble. So you use solvent extraction. Now D1 is your potassium nitrate from a mixture of potassium nitrate and potassium chloride. You will use fractional crystallization. Which method you will use? Fractional crystallization. Because potassium nitrate is more soluble in water than potassium chloride, that's why we use fractional crystallization method. Now E1 is your lead carbonate, which is insoluble, from a mixture of lead carbonate and water, because one of the component is insoluble. So what you will do, you use which method? Filtration method. Now F1 is your lead nitrate, which is soluble, from a mixture of lead nitrate and water, that is lead nitrate solution. To which method you will use? Distillation method. Right? Now next is your carbon tetrachloride from a mixture of carbon tetrachloride, which is a heavier component, and water. So means both are what? Immiscible liquids. So which method you will use? Separating funnel. Which method you will use? Separating funnel to separate carbon tetrachloride from a mixture of carbon tetrachloride and water. Now next is your benzene from a mixture of benzene, whose boiling point is 80 degrees Celsius, and toluene, whose boiling point is 110 degrees Celsius. So actually there are two miscible liquids whose boiling point are different. So which method you will use? You will use fractional distillation method, right? And last is your different dyes in their liquid constituent ink, and the method uses chromatography. Let's discuss objective type questions of chapter 3, elements, compounds and mixture. Now first is question number 1 is your select the correct answer from A, B, C, D, E for each statement given below. Now first statement is your a diatomic molecule. Which one is the diatomic molecule out of these one? First is your what? Which one? Bromine. Second is your a metalloid. What is metalloid? The elements which behave like matters and non-matters. And your answer is your what? Boron. Third is your a non-metal which is lustrous. That is your iodine. Iodine and graphite are two non-metals which are lustrous. Otherwise, all non-metals are non-lustrous. Next is your a mixture consisting of elements and a compound. That is your gunpowder. Actually, gunpowder is a mixture of which element? Sulfur, carbon, and potassium nitrate. So, sulfur and what? Your sulfur is an element. Carbon is also an element. But potassium nitrate is a compound. So it is a mixture of what? Elements and compound. Now next is a noble gas. Helium is a noble gas. Can you tell other noble gases? These are what? Neon, argon, krypton, xenon. These are other noble gases. Now next is your measure the separation of components in list 1 with the most appropriate process in list 2. Now first is your naphthalene from a naphthalene and sodium chloride. You know naphthalene is a sublimable solid. So when a sublimable solid is mixed with any other non-sublimable solid, then you can use which method? Sublimation method to separate out the sublimable solid, right? Next is your cream from milk. Cream from milk is separated by which method? Centrifugation method. Third is your kerosene oil from a kerosene oil and a water. Kerosene oil and water both are immiscible liquids. So two immiscible liquids are separated by which method? That is your what? Separating funnel. Right? Now next is your lead nitrate from an aqueous solution of lead nitrate. And which method we will use? Distillation method. Right? Now next is your ammonia from an aqueous solution of ammonia. And which method we will use? Boiling. Understood? Now next is your question number 3. The diagram represents fractional distillation or separation of mixtures. Now answer the following questions. Now first is your, actually this is what? Fractional distillation process, right? And when we use fractional distillation process, when two miscible liquids are mixed together and when we have to separate out these two miscible liquids having different boiling points. Means there is when there is a difference in their boiling point of two liquids, then we use fractional distillation. So what's your first question? Can two immiscible liquids be separated by this process? What's your answer? No. Two immiscible liquids cannot be separated by this process. Second is your separation of liquids by this process is based on which physical property? And which physical property we use? That is your difference in boiling point points of two liquids. When there is a difference in the boiling point of two liquids, two miscible liquids, then we use fractional distillation method. Now, third question is your, if methyl alcohol and water are to be separated, which liquid would remain in a flask X after condensation? And which liquid will remain in flask X? That is your what? Water. Actually, in this flask, what you will take? You will take water and methyl alcohol. And being a low boiling point of methyl alcohol, what's happened? When you heat it, this methyl alcohol start evaporating, right? And it will evaporates. But and what is left? Only water is left, as boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius. Now next is your, give a reason for the above answer. So what's your reason? Because higher boiling point of water than methyl alcohol, the methyl alcohol will evaporates faster as compared to water. Now state the purpose of the fractionating column in the apparatus. And what is the purpose of fractionating column in the apparatus? Actually, the upper part of fractionating column is cooler. Which is the upper part of the fractionating column? Actually, this portion. It is actually cooler. So as the hot vapors they rise up in the column, they get cooled or condensed and trickled back into the distillation flask X. Now next is yours. Select the correct answer from the choice in bracket to complete each sentence. And first sentence is your dust in air is an example of which mixture? Heterogeneous mixture, right? Second is your a soluble solid is separated from an insoluble solid by which method? That is your solvent extraction, because one of the component is soluble. Now next is your the reactive element from the two monoatomic element is which one? Silicon. Both are monoatomic, but neon is a noble gas, so it is what? Unreactive, but silicon is reactive element. Next is your compounds are which are always homogeneous in nature. Fifth is your an example of monoatomic molecule is helium, right? Because hydrogen is a diatomic molecule.